The cost of living is hitting pensioners hard.
I grew up in poverty. I used to watch every penny, and I still do.
The price of goods, just consumer goods, you know, at the supermarkets. I usually check out the specials.
From today, a little relief, a combination of budget and indexation increases for aged and disability support pensioners and carers, an extra $28.10 for singles to $1,140 a fortnight, $42.40 for couples to $1,725. Job seeker payments up $15.30 for singles to $786 a fortnight, $28 for couples, and parenting payment up $19.80 for singles to $1,026 a fortnight, an extra $14 for couples.
The indexation and the Commonwealth rent assistance starts today, and so they'll see that in their next payment.
Rent assistance also rising $23 a fortnight to $211 for singles, $21 for couples to $199. About 5 million people will get these increases, but the benefit will be modest at best, an average of between $1 and $2 per person per day.
That's not even going to buy a loaf of bread, a box of tissues or a can of baked beans.
The opposition supports the indexation increases.
But what we don't support is a government that's failed to win the fight against inflation.
All of these measures are there to support people with the cost of living without adding to inflation.
Still the main game. And the next big moment in the inflation fight comes on Wednesday with the monthly inflation figure for August. Westpac is predicting a fall to 2.7%, putting it back within the Reserve Bank's target range of between 2 and 3 for the first time in more than 3 years. And after the US cut its rates this week, that would increase pressure on the RBA to reconsider its call of no rate cuts before Christmas.